Hey everybody, what's up? DoubleDrive572 here, and I am alone today. Oddly enough, I am alone. And reason why I'm moving about so fast right now is thanks to the Sojourner's Sash, which was made off camera, and in case you just noticed, yes, we added at least one new mod, a few, actually, probably, I can't remember, I can't keep track, I've updated the pack many times, and yeah, I kind of made some essence armor, I did a lot, again. I just get bored sometimes. I do random stuff. I have no excuse. I never do. I never ever do. Especially with the Dark Mirror Shears sword, etc. So anyways, basically what I want to do today is show you all how to deal with the whole bit of the infinite EMC maker. And for that, we need the IC2 power generation. And I'm going to do all of that using some solar generators. Well, solar panels, not generators, which I'll probably upgrade. Wait, what? You can't upgrade them anymore? Oh, dang. Well then. Let me see. Low. Hold on. LV. No. Wow. I don't know. Well, I'll probably just be making some of those, and some macerators as well, so I'll handle the crafting off camera, but I'd like to show you exactly how it's done for those of you who probably have not seen one of our old series that was actually finished and completed. Yes, the old days of Minecraft 1.2.5. This is how far back it was. And yet, I'm going into my single player world, which I had that was pretty neat. I had never shown anyone. Basically, this is all the old school style and whatnot for pretty much everything. I'm using the default texture pack. I used to use a different one. But anyways, this right here is the setup that I'm planning on doing. Basically what we have here are alchemical chests with diamonds in them. And yet this one has blaze rods. What we have right here is a distribution pipe. Distribution buildcraft pipe. And an iron buildcraft pipe with cobble and normal stone. And they all lead up to more distribution pipe and two separate macerators. That way it will be double the production. Now, since I can actually fly in this one, basically what we're gonna try and do is the whole solar generation setup. I don't believe they have the glass fiber cables in our version. But I'll definitely see about what I can and can't do. And you see how fast that was, just a few seconds, and even more. There's always so much that can be done, no matter what. And yet, I'll probably see about making a client star or so, maybe not. But yeah, that's pretty much how it's going to be for when it's all said and done. What kind of power cables I'll use, I'll probably show you in the 1.7.10 version, so see you there. Well, it looks like I just realized how much they nerfed the solar panels, and they apparently changed the recipe of the glass fiber cable, which I actually like the fact that they changed that to something different and a bit higher end. I gotta say, it's very neat how they did that. So basically, what I'm going to do is at least go with the solar panels for now, and eventually make a kinetic wind generator, and where is it? Just kinetic generator? I'm not sure if it's both that I need, or just one. I forget how exactly it is, but what I want is windmill. Windmill and kinetic wind generator, I believe it is, that I want. So I will soon lead up to that, but first I'll at least work with the solar panels. And right here is, as far as I remember, I can at least make up to 24? Yeah, 24 maximum at the moment, but I can always make more as I go along. Well, I'm just hiding out somewhere because I apparently forgot to transfer over my mini-map data, but apparently I learned something new. Hobgoblins trade just like villagers. Huh. Pretty neat. Okay. Running back home and I find this. Just want to make sure that there aren't... Oh, well then. Those have... That's neat. Oh my. This is going to be very helpful. In some way, maybe. Not fully certain how and everything. Why do I have two Philosopher's Stones? Wow, that is just weird. Huh. Also, I made a fortune upgrade for the quarry. I forget somewhat. Oh jeez, nope. Nope. And that's fully charged. Well, just snag everything. Double check, make sure that there aren't any... Oh, there's a node. That's a sinister one. That is... No. No, 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 no. That is never good. That is never, ever good when it comes to Thaumcraft. Ah, creeper. Ah, frickin' hell. It is never good when you find a sinister node, because you just know that something bad's about to happen. So, some funky shit's gonna go down. Is pretty much how I find it every time. Basically, right now I'm just collecting a bunch of rubber because I really need it and they have zero EMC. Yep. Over here. This is the house. I think. Yep, that's the portal. I gotta remember to mark this now, because Right now I'm using a different way of loading up the mod pack that I built, as opposed to the usual, oh hey, let me just edit my Minecraft entirely using Forge. Now I'm kind of using the Multi-MC, which I enjoy. I hadn't really learned of it until recently, and now I'm like, that's pretty neat. Curse me and my forgetfulness. Okay, this is kind of funny, because generators output 10 EU per tick at a maximum, and then solar panels generate 1 EU per tick as a maximum. However, the solar panels themselves cost generators. That there, I find kind of bull. It seems like they were nerfed a little too much, in my opinion. Either that, or they just didn't really add in the low voltage and high voltage solar ones, which output more for whatever reason. At least in the version that I'm using, which is still an experimental part. So, well, I just find it kind of funny. And this is what happens when you just stay away from this long enough. Well then, that's some good EMC. What the? Oh boy. Something tells me that the lava lake has run out. I will have to go take a look on that some point, or maybe just unload it. I mean, load it, because I have not been into the Nether in a while, nor has anyone else. And let me just put this on, because I remember that I was taking a look and I read about the upgrades a little bit, so I figured out our little problems. Just a little problem. Only a little bit. So basically, I won't. Oh, well, that works. Okay, how about the? Maybe if I do this and this, and then right-click in-out mode, extract, always active. Unfortunately, right now, we still have no lava coming in. And insert mode. Then we have this in-out. Extract. Always active. No, in-out should work. But, yeah, I kind of figured out the problem slightly. Was because of that upgrade. So, basically, our problem was that this upgrade right here, the Ender Quarry pump upgrade, actually takes the liquids and wants to export them into whatever it is, such as a tank and whatnot, from one of the sides, and yet we have all sides active at the moment, so yeah, that was kind of my problem for even thinking such an idea would be good. So instead, I'm going to switch it with the Quarry Fortune upgrade and swap that pump upgrade out, because what I want to do right now is actually go to the Nether and take a look. I completely forgot that I wanted to set the wrong key. Nope. Still not right. Jeez Louise. I wanted to set a home marker. All. Boom, boom, bam. And yet, basically, I've still gotta deal with that pump. I'll probably be back as soon as I'm finished messing with that. Jeez Louise. That portal though, that portal. I gotta fix that too as well. Yeah, it seems like I had to forcibly load this chunk area, and mother of pearl, this is a lot of, wow. Just what? Oh, well then, what do we have here? Finally an Ignis node. I finally found one. And it took me how long? Probably up to at least 37 episodes by now. Oh my gosh. Finally, Ignis. Oh geez, lag. Is it safe? It seems safe. Okay, I kind of crashed for trying to pull my wand out of my bag. Or at least... Nope. Okay. I crashed twice. Thanks to you. You lousy son of a gun. Here's what I think. It's because of the data on this. So, if I pull this or move it onto my hotbar, it'll basically say, as soon as I try and hold it, I'll crash. No matter what. Watch. There we go. Yep, I'm crashed. Three in a row, go me, woo! Alright, so basically, I'm gonna need to cheaty delete it, or legit delete it. Freaking hell. There goes a bunch of freaking V that I could well damn used. I really hate that part. That is so freaking... I forgot I had so many diamonds on me. Son of a bitch. What the hell was I in here for? I think just checking the pump. Yeah. Oh well. There's so much that could be done or could be going on that I just forget almost all the time. Yeah, that's definitely dealing with it all. And look, that's pretty dang fast right there. If I had the speed 3 upgrade, it'd be going faster. I've got the fortune upgrade at the moment. It's already past a point where it probably was before. Yeah. Yeah, right there. It's definitely making the world whole like I wanted it to, so... Yeah, that's definitely working better than I wanted it. There's your problem. The pump upgrade. I was an idiot to think that it was supposed to be able to just delete them. Not actually pick them up, just delete them. When, in reality, it picks them up. Huh. Well, what do you know? Oh my gosh. I can be such an idiot sometimes, you do not even know. One purr. One purr. Okay, this is gonna take me a long time. See you when I'm done all friggin' 500 or something like that. Okay, so I'm running about aimlessly because I just realized something. I used to have two of these, where are they? Two spells. I had at least one in my bag, apparently. Plus, I did not have my sacrificial knife or my divination sigil. Apparently, things got screwed about with in my bag somehow because of the whole update process. What I'm guessing is that they got deleted thanks to the ID changes and whatnot. So, I'm gonna have to either go with it. Yeah, I'm just gonna go with it and say, the heck, I'll find everything again, I'll deal with it all and remake the healer. And I seriously checked pretty much everywhere. Nothing. So yeah. I'm gonna have to deal with that at some point. But anyways, now we've at least got both the macerators hooked up. I've still gotta make some more glass fiber cable so that I can get these solar panels hooked up properly. Alright, all hooked up and nice. Neat. Now, to see just how well it is. And I swear, you sleep, you take at least one night off, it's probably just gonna start raining. Every single damn night in Minecraft. Some people were all super excited that it was made, and now it's like, freaking hell, why? Okay, so macerators are now good and set. Be right back after I get everything set up and tested. And here we are. We have finally recreated the infinite EMC generation. We have also created the generation of power as well. So, if I just get more glass fiber cable and decide to put a room over there, I should be able to do IC2 just fine. So, let's take a look at how well this will round robin items. So the filters will be set to round robin, and well, just see how well these power up at first. Now the quartz pipe, it said that, thankfully enough, some of these had EMC, except for the stone one, which I don't really get, or the copper one. The stone one has medium drag, and yet the quartz one says that it won't connect to cobble or stone and has low drag. I'm guessing that having less drag means it's faster to move the item. So that's actually what I'm about to test right now. So Honestly, I'm not fully certain what the drag really does much for anything. I'm just guessing right now, and yet this is a test of how it'll be. Are you serious? Oh, come on. Apparently, I need to send that back and as a quartz pipe. Honestly, what I thought would happen is that. Oh. Well, that doesn't work well. Oh, jeez, are you kidding me? Anyways, what, there's like nothing else, is there? I don't see anything else, I don't hear anything going. Huh, only got two back. Kind of odd. Oh, nope, here's the third. Sprayed out randomly. So, wait, that sent both into one. That's not how it was supposed to go. So something might be off with it. Or not. So we'll see how this does with the iron pipe. If it doesn't work properly, I'm gonna have to break that and replace it with another pipe. Nope. That didn't work right. Didn't work right at all. So, I'm gonna need to at least attempt to snag all. Oh gosh. Nope. This is just not working out properly. Oh boy. Where's the wrench? Where's the wrench? Hello? Oh, come on now. Now see, that's a problem for me. I would love for it to go here, but unfortunately, you know what I think right now? I could probably hook it up to a stone pipe, then it will allow me to. My goodness gracious, this is a hassle and a half. So, be right back when I fix this up. Oh my good. Actually, no. No, I'm not gonna be right back. It's the quickest and easiest fix that I know possible. Because all you really need to do is just extend it out by one. Just extend everything out by one. Which, sure, it's definitely kind of dumb in my opinion, because the Buildcraft pipe should be doing its job. We have round robin there, we have round robin here, and it should have worked before. Unfortunately, it didn't then, for whatever reason. However, I'm just gonna set it so that these do their job. I didn't even have to remove this one. Touch anything as soon as I put this down. Wow, that is amazing. That is just crazy in my opinion, because of how it works. So, lever. And two of you. Just one. Then, oh, I'll say six here. And four here. One diamond. So that should have fixed it as far as I would believe and want to think. So I'm going to at least double check, make sure that it doesn't come out this side. Because if it round robins to there, what I'm gonna have to do is add a different pipe all along that area, and then, no, actually I would have to put an iron pipe right here, and it's round robining. All right, so that should just about do it for an infinite EMC maker. Sure, it'll be somewhat slow at first. It's how it worked before, and then it'll gradually go up. And we are out of power. Something tells me it's nighttime. It is nighttime. Nighty night. So, I hope you all enjoyed. See you next time. Actually, I forgot to mention. When I do this with the essence armor. Sure. Awesome. It's on the stand. Now, I jump normally, and I, as you can tell, still in basically normal survival, but this is 3.2.0 beta version for 1.7.10, so I'm kind of hoping that the 4.0 version is better about this, because apparently it thinks you're still wearing the armor. Look at me, I'm just flying about like crazy. You do not see the hearts or the hunger when you're in creative mode. What the hell is going on here? I swear to gods, I am an almighty flying fox. Whee! Goodbye to you all.